Latini Catholic, Vicar's opponent, Nate Skeneski, Walsh Jesuit.
So here we go.
Two unlikely finalists.
130 pound final.
No action so far. Let's get the sophomore, Rush the senior.
We got blood time right now for Skeneski.
You wanna, I'm gonna get yeah, go ahead. So right now, yep. Right now we got blood time. They cut the blood time. Am I able to respond back or how do I just put it on?
You can make it full screen, don't worry about it. Then you can see, I don't know.
There's are they writing to me?
Only a couple people are signed in the chat.
We saw blood too. I didn't realize that. We thought it was coming up. It's going to be the same amount of time. We're just cleaning up now, okay?
Yeah, both right now, just clean up, cut the blood time. Zoomed out here. Yep. We'll just do some stuff. I'm going to interview Tommy Rollins there. Get his synopsis of what's going on. So we got a second camera in. No, it's going to be good voice shots. It's going to be always be good.
Oh, you're right here.
Tommy Rollins to her right. I would love to hear it.
Oscar make it 3-0, Skaneski.
Grouping in ties. Moving out towards Ezra Matt, lowering his level now. Rash is gonna 180 drill, take him out of bounds. Getting heavy on his hands, Skaneski. You're out of bounds, 122 on the clock. The super back attempt. Skaneski, no setup, he's gonna dive in. Take down.
Too much action going on.
Back in that tie, Rush needs to get on the floor. Something. Well, that makes it 4-0. 1 minute left. Rashi needs to score this period, get back in this match. Throw by a tap right there. And elbow off Skaneski. Takes that double the wrong way and doesn't score with it. Skaneski just staying in good position here. His last shot was some counter offense. But he's gonna, it's gonna be Rash that needs to push the pace here. 13 seconds left in the second period. Shot. Trying to get a short offense going to Skaneski, but that's the end of the second period. 4-0 going into the third. Finishes that double. Oh, that would have been a huge swing. Would have gone from 4-0 to 4-3 in a few seconds, but 4-1 now. Rashi needs to push the pace to get that takedown.
Come on, Rash, push. My own mind, I might be missing it. I got to be
there for that. Skaneski, I believe, is a 9 seed. Could be wrong.
Let's go, Rash.
Rash trying to take another super dunk attempt. Really far out. I mean, distance wise, not cool. Now Skaneski on his head. Trying to go behind there. No points. We're down to one more minute. High cross attempt. Skaneski scoring using that counter offense, getting close again.
He coached a lot of winners back then.
Yeah, you can see the match.
Rash is 30, 35. Let's go. You gotta go. Come on, everything you got, man.
And there's an elbow off by the high cross there. Skaneski gonna get banged for a warning. Right on the edge of the mat, 5 seconds left in this final. First final coming to an end. Skaneski, your Ironman champ. All right, here we go, 135-pound Ironman final. That's Kixis. In on a single, he's wrestling Cam Tassari. And we got a little scramble position. Who can elevate the leg here?
Sorry, kicking him in the arm.
Sorry. Feet, nice shot, Kitsis.
Low profile.
Tassari, yeah. Not afraid to lock up.
Yes.
Lock up and throw. And that's Tassari. Tassari in on a shot, head inside. Gets his trying to 360 out of it. But Tassari's going to score first here. Wyoming Seminary, I think, third in the team race. Fourth in the team race. 5 points behind St. Ed's. Spiral and a claw in here. Comes up to his feet. We're gonna go out of bounds. 41 on the clock. Running that spiral on the claw, now going boot, like cross body ride. And Kitz is going to get his hips on top. He scores a reversal, ties it up at 2 with 24 left in the first period. Big points there. Wyoming Seminary. He'll be back in this gym March 26, 27, 28. Low Nationals. Nice. Tassari's putting one on the board. 1 point scoring at the end. Oh, look at that shiner. That's nice.
Holy cow, that's gonna bust open.
Cut it. Cut it, Mick.
Is that not common, kid?
I don't know. Yeah.
Start second period. Camp start.
Tassari on top here. Second period action.
Slick uni.
And coming up to his feet.
Big boomer.
Look at this. And oh, we almost had a raunchy return there.
It's one thing you see a lot. I haven't seen that category yet, but I'll be looking for it.
What was it?
Minute 14 left, second period. Tassari still riding tough out to the side, maybe trying to pull out a hammerlock. Kitsis gets banged for stall warning on bottom. Using that wrist. Kitsis is having trouble down there. been ridden for a minute 20 this period. And there's a short sit out, turn in. That'll tie it up at 3 with 30 seconds left. To shy away from stepping in and throwing. 2 seconds out of time, though. He'll take a 3-3 tie into the third period. Tassari on the mat. Kitsis will say he wants to go neutral. That'll make it 4-3. Seconds of the third period. On Kitsis to score as he's down by a point. Sorry. Just needs to keep good position there. We'll see how much attacking he does this period. Kitsis is the one that's been banged for stall warning. Stalemate. I crack myself up sometimes. All right, down to 40 seconds. Kitsis is going to have to get serious here. Unless he's happy with the silver. Setup, and now Tassari, tight headlock, trying to go behind, 15 seconds. We got finals at 140. Chris Villalonga, he's on the right of your screen. He's wrestling Ian Miller.
Come to the head table on the stage,
Ian
please.
Miller had no easy route. Had a barn burn last night. Isaac Jordan down in the auxiliary gym. 8-7 was the score. He's been battling every single match. Wrestled a great tournament. Villalonga's been workmanlike on his way to the finals. For the most part, dominating. And the matches that were close, it didn't seem to be in much danger. Should be a good match here. Miller's a junior, Villalonga from Blair. He's on his way to Cornell. Clearly one of the best recruits in the country.
Villalonga takes a shot from the outside, working a short offense, and has his hips back as Ian Miller. Elbows a little deep in there.
He's going to have to circle center to avoid the stall call here. He can't do that the whole match.
Out of bounds, 1:15 on the clock. Miller keeping his level low.
Both these guys have great stances, both athletes. I think they're just kind of feeling each other out, showing each other a little respect. Hopefully they start scrapping here soon. Nice, good attempt, good counter shot by Villalonga. hard. Miller with the inside tie.
Both guys battling for ties in here. You've seen Miller go feet to back a couple times. Won a match out of it in an early round against Jordan.
Great athletes, lots of shots, counter attempts. Starting to warm up here. Seeing a lot more rounds. 5 seconds.
And there's a shot, Villalonga. Villalonga takes a left-sided high crotch. Now Miller's stalking him, going out of bounds. They're getting a little aggressive.
19 seconds to go. That'll be smart game of the period.
And there's a shot. Oh, I like that left side. Now elbow off, head inside shot, trying to get into the hit. Getting a little too excited and stuttering. 9 seconds left, first period.
5 seconds first period.
And we'll end this one 0-0. And Ian Miller's going to be on top. Second period. We're in a scramble situation here. Bill Long elevates the legs and able to get in position to score.
2-0.
He puts the first two on the board here. Now keeping good forward pressure on Miller as Villalonga. Got a half in there and he's trying to bump those hips. Go back to center, 128 on the clock. Miller trying to comes to his feet, working on the hands, edge of the mat. Villalonga dropping to a leg, and we're out of bounds. 117.
Villalonga rising top. Miller slacking on the bottom.
You gotta do an interview tonight. Yeah, you know we are. All those good pictures. We're doing an interview. 116 on the clock. Good official stance right there. You could tell he was ready. Oh, and Miller comes to his feet. Villalonga catches. Ooh, caught a far side there, but now Miller clearing away. 2-1 now. Down to 40 seconds here. No one scored from their feet yet in this match.
No takedowns right now. 2-1.
Miller looks to set something up with that elbow off. But it's a shot. Villalonga clearing away.
Lots of counterattacks. Every time one guy shoots, the other guy's counterattack.
And there's an elbow off. Looking to sweep the other side. Coming back with the leg attack, excuse me, is Miller.
Miller's clearing elbows, but nothing to offense. He's clearing elbows, but nothing to offense.
And short time, we're gonna get out of this period. 2-1, Villalonga leads.
For a second, Miller will go down.
Covers. And Miller trying to come to his feet, does come to his feet. Lift and return, Villalonga.
Get
teammate was 120.
last minute of the match.
And now, Bill Long stepping out to the side. He's got that half. Miller's going to step in. Clears the lead. 2-2. Minute 7 on the clock.
First Bill Long and Ian Miller. Both guys are out there. We're probably going to see some good scrambles here. Little longer right now.
Man.
Guys.
48 seconds left. Solid 2-2 match right now.
45 seconds left. 2-2. Take down win.
And Miller gets poked in the eye. And here we go. The last 38 seconds of regulation. Bill Long moving forward here.
Bill Long right now with the inside tie.
Using some ties to set up a shot.
Bill Long inside again.
Now go off Miller. Shot. Bill Long can take the shot. Now he's caught underneath Miller.
5 seconds ago. Looks like we're going
over. And that's it. Regulation. Put a minute on the clock. Wins it here. Moving forward is Ty Miller. Bill Long setting up shots, getting heavy on the head. Miller slowing this thing down. There's a shot attempt, Bill Long. Seconds left in the first overtime. We're going to start seeing some mat wrestling again. We did see Miller got reversed to give up his 2 points. And Bill Longa did a decent ride, job of riding him. So got to give Bill Longa a little advantage right here. Whistle, that's Miller with the lift.
Phenomenal lift in return. Keep the lock. That's not one yet. That's not one yet. No control. Great
and
driving.
And Collison out of bounds with that double leg. That eats 10 seconds off the clock. A ride out here would be huge. Miller covers Bill Longer to his feet, working on hands. Working on hands. No stall calls in this match yet. Bill Longa down to the mat and comes back up. Miller's riding him. Bill Longa has a leg. 6 seconds left. Miller looking good here. Only 6 seconds on the clock, he's able to escape. And that's huge. He's ridden Miller longer than 30 seconds twice this match. Miro getting set on the whistle. Miller comes to his feet. There's a lift. Puts him back on the mat. Bill Longa.
Time to shake him.
Trying to turn in.
Step around.
seconds. 6 seconds. And Bill Long is going to ride him out for the win.
Matt wrestling is going to be the guy.
Three overtimes. Chris Villalonga, champion at 140
Chris
pounds.
Chris Villalonga just won his third consecutive Ironman title. He becomes the ninth.
All right, here we go. We got Andrew Alton. We got Squires. That's Central Mountain and Wadsworth. Alton had a really quick pin in his semifinals match, and here he goes, putting several moves together, and he's going to finish with a double leg. Alton committed to Penn State. There's the escape, 2-1.
And here we go.
We got 1:15 on the clock. And there's a shot and a reshot. Alton, he takes both of those. Squires tries to step over, take down Andrew Alton. 4-1. See if people have any questions.
I'm reevaluating. Yes,
David Taylor. So far, happening stuff. I worked out this morning, he was in there. No show.
And out to the side, Alton. Trying to run Pancake through him. That'll make it 4-2.
Oh, dark hair.
And there was a shot. Comes up with an underhook. Working that edge of the mat. 40 seconds. And there's a shot, Squires, he gets in on the hit, but Alton ends up on the leg, and then we go out of bounds with 27 on the clock. Alton looking to duck there. Getting his hands moving, going from shot to shot. Squires takes a shot in there. Official stops it, we'll get a whistle start with 14. In a boot and will get potentially dangerous. And all the skates for a point, that makes it 5-2. Squires looking to throw by. Coming back with an underhook is Alton. And Squires snaps, goes underhook. And Squires going to take a shot out of bounds. Go back to the center, 5-2. Alton getting a little, his hands busy. Throw by. Now we're over under position.
shot. Ooh. Squire sprawls right to the mat, comes back up though, no score. 30 seconds. Left. Second period. Alden was a little more active at the beginning of this match. Maybe put some points on the board. Doesn't mind slowing it down a little bit. Now Squires will be on the mat. Alden covers. 2 minutes left in this bout. Squires has his work cut out for him. Down by three. Takedown away from tying it now. Squires, he's been hitting that throw by second half of this match. And he's getting Alden to, he's getting on the move. Brings it back to the center, taking some half shots, trying to get on to react. Alden getting on the head now. Elbow off, out of bounds, 27 seconds. Shoots him out of bounds, 17 seconds. Expect Squires to be getting a little more busy here with time running out. 9 seconds. Takes a couple shots. Touched Alden's leg there. And that'll make it 5-4 now with just 2 seconds left though. Second stalling for second stall call. And that'll be it. Andrew Walton, 2009 Ironman champion. 152 pounds, Dylan Alton, he's on the right of your screen. And Jesse Shaneman. We got Blair, Central Mountain, PA, in Jersey. A battle in the finals out of the 2009 Ironman. And Alton getting busy on the head. We're going to go out of bounds. 15 seconds, tick off.
So people down behind before our mat, get ready.
There's a shot from the outside. Now Shaneman working short offense, coming up to their feet and clearing away.
Nice.
Alton in on the legs. He's going to score first.
Relay right there.
Pass it down.
Yes, ma'am. All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Dylan, he's been pushing people out of bounds. I think he's been watching Metcalf a lot lately. Semifinals, he pushed Luster out of bounds a few times. Shaneman lowering his level, getting Alton to react a little bit. We're down to 1 minute in the first period.
Last year,
bring it back to the center for a whistle start. Alton relentless on those leg attacks. He scores on his second effort. 4-1, 30 seconds. Several times, Alton just returns him as soon as he comes to his feet. That time he tries to do it, hit a switch, and now right on the edge of the mat, out of bounds. Oh, nope, end of the period, excuse me. Took him to his back. I've seen a lot of that lately. To go, they move real quick, so now he's getting on the head, circling. Out of bounds, 54 seconds. Take the shot. Damon squares up, comes from his feet, we're back in the tie. Escaping once he gets to his feet. Alton does a good job of getting that quarter turn and lift.
There's no quarter turn right there. And that time Shandeman goes switch on the way down, but they go out of bounds. 6 seconds left in the second. Be big for him to score a point here. Top now, Alton trying to come to his feet and does. Shanneman in like a lip position from the side and will go out of bounds. 5 ticks off the clock. And Alton comes to his feet, clears away.
1 point.
7-2, minute 49 of the clock. Zeb doesn't know how to act.
No, I don't.
He's from Ohio. And there's a shot at Alton. Outside, he's going to bring it down. Almost like a crackback position there. Oh, that's not a crackback position. Shanneman hanging on tight to the body. Locked around the crotch. He's still made it. 128.
That's a good thing we like for him. Do
you see Mark anywhere?
I think it's a baby. We got Cliff Fretwell in the house.
Oh, yeah. Tell Cliff this is for him.
Cliff,
we need to put it south side.
Oh, yeah. South side.
The dirty south.
Is
that another Miller? You gotta get him in on that.
Who?
Alright, here we go. 125.
I don't know.
Alton's a bleeder. He's like Loudon Swain. Shanneman needs to get something going here to get back in this match. Tough to make up 5 points on a guy like Dylan Alton in half a period, though. Middle of Alton running at those legs. Shanneman trying to get into a headlock. Seconds left. Josh and Shanneman.
All right, back to action here. 6 seconds left.
Shaneman takes a shot, Alton hits his front headlock, will go out of bounds, 23 seconds. These guys can both move really well. Do play by play when that's done.
I will recap.
More blood. By the end of this one, 8 seconds. I think they're just going to use the 7 seconds to see who can hand fight the hardest. Oh, Alton takes a shot.
Shut down though. He gets another 2-point
takedown. No, no takedown. 7-2 finish. Dylan Alton wins his Ironman title, 152 pounds.
We're now going to have an awards presentation. Everyone at the far end in front of the battling warriors, sign on the wall, clear out. We need to use our podium here.
Solzer from St. Ed's against Warp Smith at University School.
Yeah, that's fine.
You got the bracket?
You do, right to your left. No action here. I know. Dude, are you kidding me? Two Ohio guys. Come on. Okay, Salzer, Wookie, no score.
Hey, you need me to do some commentary?
Just don't curse, please.
Not a whole lot of action.
Shot by Wookie takes a shot. Here we go, got a minute left, no action. We got it late in action because Joe's an ADD baby. We got NC State. Any D1 coaches we can get and talk to, that's what we want to do. College coaches, period. Right?
What's that?
College coaches, period. We want you here.
Oh, heck yeah. I want to be here.
Good.
I love flow wrestling. I think it's one of the greatest things that's going on with our sport right now.
Cool.
We got to get you over to the NC State campus. That's what we got to do.
Raleigh-Durham. I'm not scared. I've been to Chapel Hill. I've been all around. I'm not scared. Okay. Right now, we have University of Virginia, Nick Salzer, Black Siglet, Lakewood St. Ed's, University School, Hunting Valley, Brad Wookie. No score yet. Guys feeling each other out. Wookie not committed yet. A lot of people are starting to raise their eyebrows on it. Want to know what he's doing next year. Rightfully so. We're in 15 seconds. First period. Eye poke maybe. Contact. Hey, Joe Flo. I gotta give a shout out to Heather Lott. That's my sister. She thinks I want to acknowledge her, and I love her. I just want her to know. My niece and nephew, Dawson, Faith Lott as well, and my brother-in-law, Dave Lott. Back to action here. No, I'm just letting you know. She's sending me these nasty text messages saying I want to acknowledge that I have a sister. I want her to know that we got her back. Salzer's gonna go down and start second. No score. DMAS and Ryan. On the other mat, DMAS up. One escape. Salzer. They gotta go don't pay for it. We could just turn that, but yeah. Looking at a shot. Salzer, crazy strong hips. Salzer wins the semifinal matchup. A rematch of the state final 152 state championship match over Josh Dimas, Westerville North. Salzer in deep on a shot. Wilkie tries to beat him to hips, and Salzer gets the takedown. Two takedowns, Salzer shuts him out. Brad Wookie's knee looked like it might be seized up. Brad Wookie has been riddled with injuries in his career, none which are really in his control. While the break in action,
the two matches I saw there,
Salzer senior, Wookie senior. We might not see this match finish. We got NCAA All-American over there, John Heffernan, Mark Moe's coaching. That's who he's talking to right now. He's going to be able to continue. Looks like they're doing the Lockman test on him right now. Checking his knee out. He's had an ACL surgery.
Alex did make the finals at 112. He actually
Wookie might be done here. I think we're going to...
He actually beat Joey Dans in the quarter.
Brad Wookie back to the match here. 3-0 lead. Nick Salzer. Minute 28 left in the second. Caution on Salzer. Looking trying to come up right away. He might be done. That's it. Injury default, Brad Wookie. Nick Salzer is going to be your winner. His first Ironman title, 160 pounds for the St. Edward Eagles. He's going to UVA next year.
Hey, Argue came out of nowhere, dude, from Mount Carmel.
Mount Carmel's Argue. Got Alexander of Finley.
Sophomore on the St. Paris Grand, Houston Evans. Your championship matchup at 171 from Finley, senior Michael Alexander. And a senior out of Mount Carmel, Illinois, Charles Argue.
Here we go, 171 pound final.
Argue Alexander here, getting it on. Argue's got freaky stuff, man.
Yeah, he is so
crazy.
Athletic. He's so athletic.
Crazy athletic. Chris Phillips here, he's hurt.
finish it?
Tripod up, out of bounds.
Tool lead, RU, 39 seconds left.
Start, whistle start, 38 seconds. Turn it in, Alexander, got a touchdown. One escape, back on my feet.
Inside of 20 seconds left, 2-1 lead, RU, Mount Carmel. It's Alexander.
Shot. 3 seconds.
So it's going to end the first period. RU, 2-1 lead. No false start. Other matches whistle.
And Felipe Martinez didn't wrestle. Once a bunch of studs, and they have like 10 people, and they can pull out. All right, are you clear away? 1 point.
Ladies and gentlemen, a quick reminder, Flow Nationals 2010 variety will be March
3-1 lead RU, Mount Carmel.
Right here,
Chicago boy.
All of the
RU couldn't pull it in. 1:30 left, second period.
In all placers, you'll receive a special seating consideration at the Flow Nationals, March 26th through 28th, right here at Walsh Central High School.
Alexander trying to counter shot. A lot of action between these two guys. Are you looking to go behind? No. Good exchange between the two guys.
Moriani in the house. Second period.
Hey, Florini. You getting all the winners?
Yeah.
Wait, Mark.
Lead,
argue. third period. Alexander Argue, Alexander Green Anklet, Findlay, Ohio. Argue, Mount Carmel, bronze singlet, red anklet. Takedown wins it. Alexander takes a sweeping shot. Stall call and Argue. Seconds left. 40 seconds remains. Alexander takes a shot. Argue goes to spin. Over under position. Ankle pick. Alexander steps over. Balls off. Alexander looking to gain position.
15 seconds.
Argue's trying to bust him flat. 10 seconds remain. Stubby. 10 seconds left. Alexander tries to take a shot.
Alexander going after it.
Take another one. Argue's going to spin. Score. Argue's going to win it. 5-2 for Mount Carmel. 171-pound champ.
All right, here we go. We got Max Thomaset. This is 189-pound final. And in on a low single. I'm going to have to stand up. We're getting some heads in here. Michael Evans, Blair. Two monsters. Evans takes a low shot. Thomaset sprawls, comes back to his feet, and there's a shot straight on double. That's some beef to get through. Thomaset trying to jack up some underhooks. Evans sticking with the double. Shot. Evans goes underhook. Thomaset runs straight forward with an underhook. And Evans, he's taking several shots. This time head inside. Thumbs up. Trying to drive right through. Body lock. Evans, take down. That's nice. Man, he's just persistent.
This is his first year. He was at Cumberland Valley as a freshman junior year. That's a
habit, injured.
Blair had Huntley in the finals here last year. Max Huntley.
Yeah, I guess he got hurt recently.
We got NC State now.
15 seconds on the clock. First period. Thomaset comes to his feet. Evans in on a high crotch shot. Still in control. Butt drag there. 2-0 after 2 minutes. Evans going to defer Thomaset on the mat. Thomaset tries to come up. Evans.
Oh, Evans got it.
Evans has got it like a shallow split, whatever you want to call it. Oh, man. Most people would have been in pain and pinned at the same time. And goes back to the leg. 1:43, second period.
Go back!
And nice shot.
Set Belly's back out.
Set on the mat. Oh, crunching him. Oh, man, that's a lot of pressure on his shoulder. Evans just like a killer on top.
Grab the wrist!
109 on the clock. He's got Thomas Head broken down. He's got boots in. He's extended. Doesn't look fun to wrestle Evans.
Be pretty vicious out there.
Right now, and Thomas is being trained better by Evans. Awesome. Shout out to all you. I'm glad LeBron got the
no change in position there, but he'll be feeling that when he wakes up. 38 seconds.
Win a couple Super Bowls.
Buxton doesn't like to stop in action.
38 seconds.
And now coming to his feet, Thomas F.
Thomas
F. He's going to get a reversal here.
Reversal!
Take down.
He's
going to tie it up.
He's got the leg here.
Now Thomas F.
Now Thomas F's going to be
riding legs now.
So, wants to get a little payback here.
I don't win.
15 seconds.
Jack.
Go Max.
But he's going to give up for Evans. Evans going to score at least one here. I make it 3-2. That's a big point for a short time. That's going to cut him. It's going to make it 4-2. And Evans had that nice combination in the first period when he came out of body rock. Now Thomas Sett's going to... Take home an Ironman title. Oh, still cranking on there. Add a little bit to the end of the match.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, 215 drill points. Good place to junior on Meslin, Barry Anthony Wise.
Here we go, 215 pounds, Ironman finals. We have Knowles Chapel, Cavalry Chapel. He's a junior, he's wrestling Bo Wanger. And Knowles really impressed me in the semifinal match, just the way he moves. He's good with his hands, snaps and spins. He's also got low shots and high crotches. Not familiar with Wanger. There we go, the Metcalf push. Out of bounds push. And here, Wanger takes a shot. There was a stop in action. 129 on the clock.
Jersey's got one division, but not that many players now. That's true.
And now it's Knowles working on those snaps. Release Benny, releases pressure and snaps. Shot Wanger now. Oh, he peeks out.
I don't normally see the big boys do a peek out.
Yeah, these guys, they even look big. They don't wrestle like 215 pounders. No one moving forward again. Setting up that snap down, I believe. He takes a shot. Knee pull.
215 pounds.
He scored like 7 or 8 takedowns in his first match. First period, scoreless. Both guys showing some athleticism. And a stall on Wanger. That's his first point. And there's another knee pull. Comes up high single now. Short time to finish. Wanger gets his hips down. Pretty exciting 0-0 period for 215 pounders. Like it. Trying to come up off the mat, Wanger. And Knowles looking to tilt. Still good forward pressure. We get a stalemate though, 123. Knowles still on top. Wanger tries to switch. Oh! Yeah, he cleared away. No change in position.
Are you
comes up to his feet, working on those hands. Quarter turn right there, and a return. Bring it back to the center, 108. Minute 35. Knowles on the mat.
Of course.
All right, we're back.
Here we go. Knowles right to his feet, clears away. Oh, look at him. He's ready to roll. Up 5-2. Scored. It's a snap down. Score that takedown, the first one. And a diving shot. He's trying to peek out again. He saw a peek out earlier in the match. But the last time he saw it like that, Knowles scored. Capitalizing off the attempt. Takes a shot, counter offense. I'm gonna cut him. Oh man. getting physical here. There's something about this guy. Something about this guy. 42 seconds. Blood time again. Forward, working those snaps, and Hall slips on the mat. That was horsepower right there, and he wants more. Guy.
Wow, look at this guy.
Running back to the center to wait. 22 seconds. This guy doesn't get tired. Right there on the edge of the mat with 12 seconds. Knowles wants more, takes a shot. Stuck underneath as time expires. Knowles gonna win here, 9-4. Up 1 second. William Knowles. Ironman champion, 215 pounds. He's got him bouncing around like he's a 125 pounder. Let's go! Let's go! 285 pounds. We got big, bad Mike McMullen.
McMullen versus Buzzelli.
Wyoming Seminary. And we have Buzzelli, the big boy from Wadsworth. And Buzzelli running forward with some underhooks. McMullen is put together, but he looks like he weighs about 30-40 pounds less than Buzzelli.
I'm probably gonna slide over here because I'm gonna do the thing down here, right?
I'll move down there. And there's a shot coming up, McMullen. Head inside. High single style.
Big Ben Buzzelli.
Boom, two. And there's the escape. Buzzelli's coming right after him, stalking. Right back in on his shot, McMullen. It's gonna be tough to finish there on the edge of the mat. Those are some big hits too, but staying on that leg. We need to get Floriani. And we're out of bounds, 57 on the clock. Six seconds. Still neutral, 2-1.
It's 2-1, 25 seconds remaining.
Buzzelli, I saw he got a fall in the finals over a broken arrow. McMullen wrestled a monster, but won 5-0 with about 5 minutes riding time. What's up, Flo?
Yeah, but you're commentating.
All right. All right. 23 seconds left. Sitting in the tie. Now breaking away. This is when McMullen sets those shots up. Some fakes. Buzzelli really doesn't react when he fakes. I think most of the time people shoot on him. It doesn't matter. He gets those hips on him. There's another fake. And short time. The towel wapper is out. 2-1. McMullen after 2 minutes. It's gonna be
all right. We gotta make the shift real quick.
All right.
We got Tommy Rollins back. Whoop. Here. We're gonna put him back.
Get in front of him.
Put him back in. We're gonna do some stuff with you, Rob.
Tommy Rollins. Let's move this down. Bear with me.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the conclusion of the heavyweight matches, we will have an awards presentation.
All right.
Once again, conclusion of the heavyweight matches, we will have an awards presentation.
All right. So. 10 seconds in the second period. Bazzelli's on top. Ryan McMullen a little bit. McMullen goes tripod. Riding tough right now, not able to turn, but keeping McMullen stuck on the mat. And we got potentially dangerous. I missed it. There we go. Bazzelli goes angles. This time McMullen's up to his feet. Bazzelli drops to a leg. And McMullen clears away. We're neutral. 3-1. Bazzelli trying to dig underhook. For comfort. There's a slide by attempt, Bazzelli. Digging under hooks, working for inside ties, both guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, if anyone finds a video camera in the stands, please turn it in to the main table.
Second period. 3-1. McMullen. Bazzelli on the mat now. Bazzelli trying to come up, but McMullen giving some good forward pressure, gets a breakdown. We saw in the semis match that he can ride. Tripod, Bazzelli. He's up and he's out. 3-2, minute 37. Trying to clear out McMullen, he's digging inside and we're cleared away. 120. A shot on the edge of the mat. McMullen, Bazzelli's starting to get an angle, but oh, if he can readjust and score, that's crazy. That close to the edge of the mat, and he does. Take down McMullen, wow. How did he do that right on the edge? It must not be as close as it looks from here. But that puts him up 5-2 now, which is 51 seconds. Bazzelli sits out off the whistle. Down on top. McMullen probably just gonna try to finish this match out with the ride. Down to 20 seconds. I'm sure Coach Gordon would enjoy some fall points here, but an Ironman champ will do.
Mike McMullen, keeping the McMullen family in the gold medals. His brother won it here last year. Wyoming Seminary, crushing. Here we go. 103-pound Ironman final. We got Dean Kyle, Montini Catholic. And George DiCamillo.
DiCamillo.
There's two L's. Doesn't it make the Y sound?
Yeah, but he's from St.
Ed's. What did I say?
You said Montini.
Another reminder.
The guy who wrestled in the semi was Montini Catholic. All right, now that we got that all together.
The winner of each weight bracket in the 2009 Ironman will automatically have the second place seed in the nationals. And everyone who places in the 2009 Ironman will have a special seating consideration for the 2010 World Nationals. March 26th to the 28th, right here.
Okay, so wrestle from their knees right now. DiCamillo, short offense, up to his feet, and dropping it on Shoppa's heel, controlling an elbow now. Now there's a shot, DiCamillo trying to finish backside on that swing single. Seconds on the clock. Short time points are big points. 2 seconds, not going to be able to score. 0-0 after 2 minutes.
There you go, Georgie.
Check this hat out. That is a sweet hat. Can I wear it whenever I go up there and do a. Can I put it on? It'll make people laugh. All right, here we go. DiCamillo on the mat. Trying to find a boot that Hill is trying to put in. Kyle fighting his wrists under there. Gonna get a good breakdown here. DiCamillo's shoulders popped out of there. Down to 105. DiCamillo coming out from behind. Take there, or that's a reversal. DiCamillo up, scores the first points, 2-0. Hale trying to come to his feet. He is to his feet. Brought back into a crab ride. DiCamillo working those wrists underneath. And another reversal is coming up. Not yet. There it is. That'll tie it up at two. Only, short time. 13 seconds left. Off the whistle, DiCamillo
comes to his feet, tries to switch back to his feet, broken down by Heel. And now he's running a claw and a spiral. Two after two periods. Is leading. Some good hand fighting there. Down to 1:27 on the clock. DeCamillo in a position where he's going to have to get after it, force a flurry, find a way to get a takedown here. But it's Hale that takes a shot. DeCamillo in, head inside shot, straight forward. It's under a minute to go in this final. Coming at us. Out of bounds, 49 seconds. DeCamillo takes down, gets a lead now. I missed that 30 seconds. That hurts. He's gonna have to ride cup for 29 seconds.
No song call.
And Heil comes to his feet. DeCamillo trying to hang on in there. Nothing yet. He stays in control. He's still in control on the edge of the mat. That was nice wrestling. 16 seconds. Up to his feet. Brought back into crab ride. 10 more seconds to ride to force overtime. And he's going to put it in overtime. 3 seconds. Put a minute on the clock. Please put a minute on the clock.
Hey, George, you missed your match.
DeCamillo, the only one with a takedown in this bout. Other points are reversals and escapes and clasping. Takedown wins it.
Use your speed.
And DeCamillo takes a shot, he's in deep. Head inside, swing single. Oh, but Hale just cranking a quarter Nelson. Nothing there, nothing yet. Still hanging on, that looks tough in there. How tough are you? Oh, he's able to get in good position here. 10 seconds on the clock. Both guys so close to scoring there. That's from him.
Let's go.
in overtime in reverse will be huge. That's huge points. If he can stay on top for 22 seconds, DeCamillo is really setting himself up. Especially with no stall warnings here. Oh, but the escape heel. That's huge for him. But if you remember, we got 8 seconds left here.
I need a representative from Blair Academy to the stage. I need a representative from Blair Academy to the stage, please.
Drop the knee!
No way.
Evans.
Evans?
Gotta get away! Oh,
6-5. And he's grabbing a headgear on bottom. We all saw it. So that's going to be 9 seconds. That's huge. Both guys give up a penalty point in this match in that one. Why would
no? No.
You want to go out to start? We got 7-5 match, 9 seconds. Drops to the leg. DeCamillo hangs on. Crazy match. DeCamillo, the Ironman champ at 103 pounds. 112 pound final. We got Blair in New Jersey and we got California. That's Alex Cisneros in the black and orange, Fresno Valley, Selma High School. He's wrestling silver. It's a 112 pound final. Cisneros, undefeated state champ at 103 last year in California. Big accomplishment. Now moving up to 12. Getting things going, 112 pounds. Just not a whole lot of action. Start off working in ties, feeling each other out. Looks like Silver's got a little size on Cisneros. Cisneros drops in, looking for a single leg. Comes up, putting some pressure on his head as Silver. We're down to a minute. First period. And Silver gets in deep. Deep penetration. He's going to get the first takedown. And crunching forward and good breakdown. Silver, 23 seconds left. Cisneros would be good, really good for him to get out. Get a point on the board before we head into the second period. Silver covers, Cisneros looking to come to his feet. Silver drops to the leg. Out of bounds, 10 seconds. And then Granby. That's it. 2-0 lead for Silver going into the second period. I believe Cisneros was in that same situation against Dance in the quarterfinals. Joey Dance won the Super 32. I don't see him wrestling. What place did Dance get, you know? And now Silver getting things going on bottom. Ooh, an opportunity to score reversal. He gets an escape. Makes it 3-0. Cisneros keeping his level kind of low. Comes up now. Working that tie. Cisneros lowers his level. Looked like he might try to hit a duck there. Working for some control, some ties here. 110, second period. Cisneros drops in on a shot. Sweep single, Evan Silver. Squares up, we're going out of bounds. Silver drops in on a high crotch, comes back to his feet. Doesn't get past Cisneros' hands there. Cisneros quick, hits his, looks like he was gonna shoot a double. Now, Silver in deep again. Man, both shots that he's really committed to, he's gotten really deep. And now, putting the pressure on, scoring some near fall. And that was just some power right there. Scoring a 2 and 3 near fall. That'll make it 7-0. 12 seconds left in this period.
5-0 lead,
it's gonna
be 8-0. Silver doesn't look like it's gonna get
long. Wow, that was takedown and just jamming Cisneros. Cisneros will be on the mat.
We
got a lot of points to make up. Up really quick off the whistle. And looking at a reversal there. Man, Cisneros gets things going. He scores, but now Silver's gonna get at least one here. You would think, yep, we're neutral. And Cisneros gonna try and drag. Cisneros looks like he's getting a little more movement. Silver slows it down in that tie. And there's another attempt. Low single, he gets in deep. Minute 12, he's gonna need to get some turns. Silver staying strong on bottom, just keeping his base position there. Down to 50, and they're gonna stalemate it. Super duck. So we're keeping a good square stance. Keeping head position. And this time it's just narrow slow single. And Silver's getting on the head. 26 seconds. Thank you. Cisneros takes another shot, and Granby and some shrugs there. Silver's gonna score one. Nope, doesn't score yet. That's gonna be a 10-4. Good match. Both these guys are great wrestlers.
You're right. You're right.
Here we go.
Hunter
Steamer. Okay, 119 pounds. Finals at the Ironman. We got Hunter Steamer, Moreauville, and Beckman Reynolds. We got a whistle start 141. Sorry, it took me a little long to get to this. Steamer attacks ahead. Both wrestlers on their knees right now. And Beckman in on a swing single, head inside. Trying to finish backside. Steamer with the deep whizzer in there. And Steamer trying to go cross ankle. Locked around the cross now as he spun around. Stalemate position, we'll get one, 106 on the clock. Steamer in on front headlock there. Get another stalemate, 44 seconds. Comes back to his feet. We get out of the first period scoreless. Steamer on the mat, second period, comes to his feet. Hit switch, turns back to in, goes shrug, up to his feet. Beckman drops in on a leg, right there on the edge of the mat. A lot of action right there, no points scored yet. And we're out of bounds. Mark Perry. Steamer comes to his feet. And Sagan going to a leg. Beckman gonna drive him out of bounds, double leg. Almost runs into Jerome Robinson over there. The third place match. Trouble getting off the bottom, we're down to 113. Beckman hasn't come close to turning him, but he's riding him hard. Right as I say that, he chops an arm and gets a breakdown.
Wow. favor.
Steamer comes to his feet. We got 2-on-1, roll through tilt style, but we're going out of bounds. And there's opportunity to score. No score. Whatever I hear Zeb say, I gotta say it. For 2 minutes and have a 0-0 scoring opportunity to choose in the third period, setting himself up. 20 nothing, seconds.
Nothing has happened so far in this match.
And Hunter Stever comes to his feet, dropping in on the leg. Beckman, been here several times, locked around the crotch. Here's Stever. We're not going anywhere from here. The towel wapper on his way out, so we got short time, 4 seconds on the clock. And Beckman's gonna get a ride out. That's big, 0-0 going into the third period, and Beckman chooses bottom.
Beckman is an absolute dark horse stud who has put himself on the national map, no doubt about it.
Hunter Stever recovers, whistle blows, not a lot of action, but Stever out to the side. He's got a claw, and he was running spiral now. A sit-out position for Beckman. And he's just staying in position there. Peeling hands, trying to come, knee slides. Back to sit out position. Stever keeping his hands behind those armpits, and we go out of bounds with 140.
Still 0-0, no score. No stall warning. Jim Jordan, a great American, period.
And we got caution, Stever. Stever trying to cheat. Who wanted a Jerome Robinson here?
No, Versetta.
All right, here we go, 136, the clock's ticking, and the breakdown for Stever. Back to that sit-out position, Beckman trying to peel off that claw hand. Well, Stever seems comfortable in there.
This weight is ridiculous.
And
you got
out of bounds.
Beckman just put himself on the map. Stever, Jerome Robinson, Nick Versetta, Ty Mitch, Mark Gray. I think Mark Gray just took, was that fifth, sixth?
Fifth and sixth, I don't know.
Mark Gray just took sixth place.
Right.
A two-time.
We're neutral.
Four-time national champion.
We're neutral, there's a point. So 1-0 lead for Beckman, and Stever's gonna be forced to push the pace here, make something happen, create some flurries. Underhook, right on the edge of the mat. Beckman wrestling off his knees. Stever putting some pressure on the back of his head. The official's in my way. And we're out of bounds with 47 seconds.
Beckman, this would be huge, period. This would be biggest upset. He might be my OW. Winning the toughest league.
Oh, Stever!
Beckman's in on a shot! Stever tries to kick over! You take down Beckman with 36 seconds left. Whoa!
Nice counter offense. Stever goes, jacks up an underhook, tries to hit an ankle pick, and Beckman finds his way to the legs. 30 seconds left, 3-0.
Stever looking to come out. Beckman checks, follows, covers. Now they're in a. Stever's looking to step over. Quick stoppage, 22 seconds left. Don't know what the stoppage was, but
22 seconds. I'm still 3-0 lead for Beckman running from Pennsylvania.
And didn't know what the stoppage was for. Looking at the official, that was pretty quick.
20 seconds off. Speeder switching. Beckman hanging on to the single leg. Beckman wearing a Kent State shirt around, people.
Zeb's gotta love it.
Star warning. Beckman.
11 seconds. 11 seconds. Beckman picks up his Ironman title. And we move to the match of the night. And back on those legs. Driving forward. That's going to be it. 2 seconds on the clock. And Beckman, your champion at 119 pounds. Selection for the crowd.
Beckman up and nails.
Eagles versus Blue Demons. Joe Flo missed the entire first period. Well, we got it. We videotaped ourselves doing this. One escape.
That's the first point of the match. Logan Stever escapes the one. Took about 8 seconds.
And one of the major awards we will be awarding is a major rating and noticeable award.
And it's moving forward, Carter with an underhook.
All of you, please keep your seats. First time this award has been given out anywhere in the United States.
Both guys keeping an arm down over their lead leg.
The wrestler
who contact now
earns the most team points.
Minute 20 left. Crunched him, body lock. Period, bear hug, Logan Stever, horsepower, third in the US Open. That's all I gotta say.
3-0 Stever, minute 11 on the clock. Here we go. Good breakdown, Stever. Carter having trouble getting to his base now. A little spread out down there. Deep waist and good forward pressure for Stever.
Turned out potentially. Carter is sneaky strong. That just tells you how sneaky strong Logan Stever is.
And now a switch attempt. Carter comes to his feet, working hands. Stever drives to the edge of the mat, but he escapes just in time. 3-1.
40 seconds remains, 3-run lead. Logan Stever, Eagles.
Devin Carter, Blue Demons.
25 left.
There's that 2-on-1 again. As soon as he goes 2-on-1, Carter gives him the old thumb block in the jugular. Fifteen seconds, a short time. Looking dragged there was Carter. We're cleared away, still wrestling right in the center of the mat. 5 seconds, Carter gets his hands moving. We're gonna go into the third, 3-1.
3-1, Logan Stever. Eagles. Blue Demons. Hawkeye. Cyclone.
All right, here we go, Carter on the mat. Comes to his feet, feeling hands. Leg, and we're on our feet. We got a 1 point match, 3-2. Let's see how Carter, that's a nice shot.
Oh, he ran him over! Oh, no, they came looking for the ball! Oh, he shows why he's the man.
Crunches him again.
Logan Freak Stever, wow.
And that'll do it. The score now, 7-2.
8-3, check that. Logan Stever. Wow, I thought Devin Carter was too strong. He runs him over again. No score though, now he's in deep. Carter shows you why his hips are so strong.
And his hips back, but just a minute 8. Tough to make up 5 points on this guy.
Stever, Eagles. Daryl Weber, coach of Devin Carter. Here we go, single leg, head inside, single leg. Logan Stever, Daryl Weber, Hawkeyes.
Forcing a stalemate. Devin Carter getting his hips in, chest up. Stever can't finish the shot. 35 seconds left in this tournament.
Stever's gonna get that one. He's got bothered with the far ankle.
Oh, man.
Two takedowns. Logan Stever, 10, 3, 25 seconds left. Keep it in the viewfinder.
What? Why you calling me out?
This is just like Russian nationals all over. Except for no awkward robot or golf cart. Go party.
Again, 4:10. Now we're back on our feet, and that's going to be it. Logan Stever with the win.
Definitely my OW now. He's pumped too. He's pumped. 10-4 win for the super hydraulic freak of nature, Logan Stever. And it's in the books. It's over. Blair dominating. It's not in the books actually. Delgado